Hello, my dear friends. I hope you are doing well. In this PPT, I am going to discuss the torque produced by variable or switched reluctance motor. As all the electric machines are designed to work at the verge or just below the saturation level, the magnetizing characteristics of the machine in the working region may be assumed as linear. So, the field coenergy may be given as Wf dash is equal to half I square into L theta, where inductance L is a function of angular position of the rotor angle theta. And hence, the torque produced is given by change in coenergy with respect to the rotor angular position theta, where I is the instantaneous value of current, L is the self-inductance of the phase winding, and theta is the angular position of the rotor. The sign of the torque produced is independent of the direction of the flow of current, as the torque is proportional to the square of the current. The sign of the torque produced, however, depends on the variation of self-inductance of phase winding with rotor angular position theta. The nature of the inductance variation, whether positive or negative slope, depends on number 1, the number of stator poles and rotor teeth, and number 2, pole arcs of the stator pole and the rotor teeth. For understanding the self-inductance variation with respect to the rotor position, we are going to refer figure given in this slide. अगर आप इस फिगर ए को ध्यान से देखें तो ये रोटर जो है वो क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में मूव कर रहा है एंड द रोटर टीथ जस्ट आ रहा है पोल ए और ए डैश के नीचे विच करस्पॉन्ड्स टू थीटा इज इक्वल टू 0 degree एंड सिंस एयर गैप इज मैक्सिमम एट दिस पोजीशन विच मीन्स रिलक्टेंस सबसे ज़्यादा है सो एट दिस टाइम आपका इंडक्टेंस जो है वो मिनिमम होगा. अब फिगर नंबर बी पे आते हैं. The maximum overlapping of stator pole and rotor teeth is shown in figure B. Air gap सबसे minimum है, तो reluctance सबसे कम होगा and inductance will increase from minimum to maximum value when the rotor rotates through an angle of 0 degree to theta 1. अगर ध्यान से figure C को देखा जाए, तो figure C में there is barely any rotor displacement, so inductance will remain constant at its maximum value. फिगर डी में रोटर मूव्स फ्रॉम थीटा 2 टू थीटा 3. एयर गैप इज अगेन मैक्सिमम सो इंडक्टेंस विल डिक्रीज फ्रॉम इट्स मैक्सिमम वैल्यू टू मिनिमम वैल्यू. नाउ दिस साइकिल इज बीइंग रिपीटेड फॉर ईच हाफ रोटेशन ऑफ द रोटर थ्रू वन पोल पिच फ्रॉम वन पोल टू अनदर. अब जो भी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड हैज बीन शोन ग्राफिकली इन दिस स्लाइड. Here you can see at theta is equal to 0, inductance ki value is minimum. As rotor moves from 0 to theta 1, the inductance increases from its minimum to maximum value. From theta 1 to theta 2, the maximum value of L is retained. And again, from theta 2 to theta 1, the inductance returns to its minimum value. Also, the nature of torque developed is also shown in this figure, and since the torque is directly proportional to the change in inductance with the angular position of the rotor theta, the torque will be produced by the machine whenever there is a change in the inductance value. Here you can see it very clearly in the graph ki jab aapka inductance mein koi change nahi hai us time pe torque produced by the machine is equal to 0. So what we have concluded from the previous slide, that the self-inductance of the phase AA dash is minimum corresponding to the rotor angle theta is equal to 0 degree and the torque produced at that time is 0. The self-inductance of the phase AA dash increases linearly from minimum to maximum value for theta is equal to 0 degree to theta 1 and the torque produced is maximum at that time with a positive sign. When the rotor moved from theta 1 to theta 2, the torque produced is 0 because there is barely any change in the self-inductance of the phase AA dash. The self-inductance of the phase AA dash decreases linearly from maximum value to minimum value for rotor displacement of theta 2 to theta 3 and the torque produced is minimum with a negative sign. And the self-inductance of the phase AA dash is constant at its minimum value from rotor displacement angle theta 3 to 180 degree, and hence torque produced is zero due to zero slope for the self-inductance. And this cycle is being repeated for each half rotation of the rotor through one pole pitch from one pole to another, as I have discussed in the previous slide. So what are the observations we had from the previous discussions? From the previous waveform, it is clear that the torque produced is positive for positive slope of self-inductance, is negative for negative slope of self-inductance, and is zero for zero slope of self-inductance. But it is quite obvious from the waveform of torque that the average torque produced is zero for this condition, as waveform of the torque is symmetrical about x-axis. So how to make the torque unidirectional? A positive value of average torque may be produced only when the phase winding is excited for the region where the slope of self-inductance is positive and remains unexcited when the slope of self-inductance is negative. This has to be followed for all the stator phases of the motor in sequence in order to produce a positive torque and to continuously run the motor meeting the load demand. And in order to determine the switching instance for different phase windings on stator, a rotor position sensor is essential. This has to be followed for all the stator phases in the motor in sequence in order to produce the maximum torque and to continuously run the motor. So that's all for this lecture. See you in the next one. Till then, stay safe. Stay healthy.